So as I've evolved as a photographer with my editing, I found that I've moved away, or I've evolved from using a style that is more in your face and over the top and bashes you over the head. That's kind of what I enjoyed years ago. Now, though, I feel like my editing style is more subtle, nuanced, and natural. And there is one slider in Lightroom. If there was only one slider that I can use, it'll be this one that I'm going to show you in this video, because I think it does such a magical job of just bringing out the natural beauty within the photo. So let me show you what I mean. All right, so here I just created this simple image in Photoshop. It's just a white background with three circles. One is red, one is green, and one is blue. And I mentioned that I prefer now that the look of my images to be nuanced and just bring out the natural beauty of things. So what that means in my mind is to make these colors look the best that they can based on the subject matter. And so normally you would think, all right, well, that probably just means that you're going to scroll down over here and use the color mixer tools. And to a degree, you'd be correct, but that's not actually the one slider that I was just talking about. So rather than build up the hype anymore, let me show you what I'm talking about. If I scroll down right here under color grading, that's kind of weird. It's not here. And there's a good reason for that. That's because it's hidden by default. So I'm kind of making a little bit of a lame joke, but the truth is, I think most Lightroom users don't even know this specific slider and panel exists. Even Lightroom Classic users, for the most part, don't use this. And it's been available in Classic as long as I can remember. Let me show you how to get to it though. So there is a sub panel here that's hidden. And the way that you would access it is by clicking on this ellipse over here and then going to show color calibration. You see now this new panel appears and you have these sliders. You've got red, green, and blue primary sections, and you have hue and saturation sliders for each of those three colors. And if you go to Lightroom Classic and you open an image up in the develop module, if you scroll to the bottom, you'll see there is a calibration section here and you have those exact same sliders. So everything I show you here will work the same whether you're using Lightroom or Lightroom Classic. However, it is only for the desktop apps. It is not currently available on the mobile apps. Now, before I show you the slider that I'm talking about, you might be asking, well, why is it red, green, and blue? At least I did. And it actually makes a lot of sense. And that's because all of the displays that we use, whether it's our monitors on our laptops or on our phones or tablets, they're made up of pixels, right? And actually, pixel stands for picture element. So each pixel contains three colors, which you guessed it are red, green, and blue. And the combination of those colors being active in each pixel, you can get, I mean, all different kinds of hues, and that's how you get your images displayed. Now, this is a super, super high level explanation of it, but I thought it was worth bringing up. So if we jump back over here to Lightroom, the one slider, I mean, this slider I would say is the biggest difference maker, is the blue primary saturation slider. So let me explain to you why you might ask, would you want to use this blue primary saturation slider instead of the saturation slider? You can see under color mixer, we are in saturation. Why wouldn't I just want to use the blue? Well, if you think about color mixer and the color calibration panels, the color mixer is, I guess would be the closest thing would be equivalent to using like a masking tool. And you use a masking tool when you want to make a local edit. You want to make an edit to a specific area of your image. Color calibration is kind of like using the vibrance or saturation or the tone sliders, which are global. You're making adjustments to the entire image. So again, color mixer is adjusting colors specifically, and the color calibration sliders will adjust the color in every single pixel in your image. So let me show you what I mean in practice. Again, I've got color mixer and we're going to blue. So we're looking at this dot here. Watch, when I bring it to the left here, you see how only that blue circle is being affected. The red and the green are not being touched. Now, check this out. If we go to the same equivalent, blue primary saturation, when I go left and right, you see how all three dots are being affected. And that's because the color blue in every single pixel in the entire image is being changed, the saturation of blue rather. So you can see here, it's being affected in every single pixel. The same thing goes for hue here. It's adjusting the hue. Now, admittedly, I really don't adjust the hues, partly because I'm red-green colorblind, so two of the three primary colors here, I have a hard time differentiating between them. Blue, I can see great. And so I found that when I edit my photos, and I'll show you actual examples in a minute, but I found that just working with saturation, really the blue saturation slider rather, it does an amazing job. So let me show you what I mean in practice. Let's go ahead. I'm going to switch from my local tab to cloud over here, and I've got this folder ready. So in the grid view, I'm going to start simple with this image over here. So this is a unedited photo. You can see the sliders, tone curve, everything is pretty much as shot straight out of camera. The only thing I'm going to do here is go down to the color calibration section and move the blue saturation slider. And when I do, you see how just how much more vibrant all of the colors, not just ironically, not just blue, but the greens and the reds become just more pronounced. And the easiest way to show you is if I click on this eye icon. So this is the original image, and this is the image with only the blue primary saturation slider brought to 100. You don't have to bring it to 100. In this case here, I just happen to think that it looks really good. And of course, you could also use these other saturation sliders if you want. Like with the green primary saturation slider, I can bring this out and it just makes the colors more rich. And again, even though I'm red-green colorblind, I can see some shades of green and I can see that this just looks beautiful. And when I toggle the effect, it's magical. Like it's just, even without this slider, with just the blue saturation slider, the edit is so good. And that's why I'm saying that this one slider is so impactful. So let me show you another image here. Again, you can see here, no edits. It's all pretty much straight out of camera. All I'm going to do is take the saturation for the blue primary section here under the color calibration panel, and I'm going to bring it out. And you can see how all the foliage just is starting to pop and it just looks more vibrant, but it doesn't look over the top. That's what's key. It doesn't look like it's oversaturated or anything. It just looks more natural. And I love that. Again, you can go ahead and play with the green saturation here. Usually what I'll do is I'll kind of go left and right and then I'll slow it down until it kind of lands on a good area. And then with the red as well. And the combination of these sliders here are, there's almost not much else that I need to do other than maybe fix the tone and do any other kind of corrections, like removing any dust spots or any distractions. And then the last image that I want to show you is actually an iPhone photo. So those first two photos were taken with Sony mirrorless cameras, but I wanted to show you that this works just as good with mobile photos. So all I'm going to do here with the blue primary, just like the other two images, is I'm going to start bringing it up. What I have found is with mobile photos, especially when you're using ProRAW, which is Apple's version of RAW, it's a processed RAW file using its Photonic engine. You need to be a bit more careful. It's easy to push the colors too far with mobile photos. You still should use these sliders, but just be more careful about it when you're editing. So here you can see if I brought it to 100, it looks good, but it does look a bit over the top. So here I would actually bring this back to right around almost halfway. And then I'd also look at how the other sliders here work, like the green primary saturation, it looks really good. And then I'd go with red. And so, like I said, even though I use the green and the red primary saturation sliders, if there was only one slider that I could only have access to in that panel, for example, it would without a doubt be the blue primary saturation slider. It's been part of my editing workflow for a while now. And generally, if not the very first thing, it's one of the first things I do. Sometimes if I can tell that there is a color cast to the image, I'll get a correct white balance, and then I'll work with the color calibration sliders. But for the most part, it is one of the most powerful tools. And I know I kind of glanced over it. I'm going to create a separate video specifically on the entire color calibration panel. So be sure you're subscribed to get notified of when that video comes out. But in the meantime, though, if you are interested in Lightroom and you want to learn everything, not just the color calibration section, but everything that I showed you, including how to manage all of your photos across all of your devices, whether it's with Lightroom desktop or mobile, please check out my course called Lightroom Everywhere. The link's in the description below. Again, you don't have to take my word for it. I have so many wonderful student testimonials. I'm so grateful for them. You can check them out on the product page, which again is linked below. When you enroll, you are directly supporting my small business, and I cannot thank you enough for that. It allows me to continue making these fun videos for you. And if you want to learn more about how to work with color, check out this video on Lightroom's new point color tool. It's amazing. If this video was enjoyable, a thumbs up is always appreciated. And like I said, be sure to hit the subscribe button and click on the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.